welcome Abdur-Rahim Muhammad.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Again, my name is Abdur-Rahim Muhammad, the founder and president of the Hung Tao Choi Mei Leadership Institute, the producer of tonight's event. We welcome you to U Street, one of the most progressive communities in all of the United States, and to the historic Lincoln Theater, one of its greatest cultural treasures. We believe that the program you will witness tonight will be remembered as one of the proudest moments in the Lincoln's history. Tonight we will present legendary entertainer and humanitarian, Mr. Harry Belafonte, with the Here I Stand Award, named in honor of the great Paul Robeson. Our intention is to recognize each year an individual who has made a substantial contribution to humanity, because like Paul Robeson, they make no separation between their work as artists and their work as human beings. Any program featuring Harry Belafonte is off to a good start. However, when that program is graced with the participation of Danny Glover and Paul Robeson Jr., then you'll have to admit that something very special is taking place. So prepare yourself for more than an interesting and very entertaining evening, but an evening that will make history, because appearing together for the first time will be Harry Belafonte, Danny Glover, and Paul Robeson Jr. And all of them embraced by the courageous spirit of the great forerunner and bearer of culture, Paul Robeson. The program we're presenting tonight, and others we've presented here in the past, are done for the immediate good they provide, and also to provide our students with an opportunity to gain valuable experience and planning, organizing, and executing projects which promote healthy living and personal responsibility while providing a view into history from the mouths of those who shaped it. Our Leadership Institute is more than just a martial arts organization, but an organization of martial activists committed to excellence in our chosen art and equally committed to working towards social and economic justice within our community. And the intense training regimen at the Hung Tao Choi Mei Leadership Institute is preparation for living a meaningful life. And finally, this program is a collective vision of local activists who long to have our noble heroes and forebearers uncovered, rediscovered, and elevated to the lofty heights where they belong. So ladies and gentlemen, once again, welcome to U Street and our beautiful Lincoln Theater. We hope that you will enjoy our program, and we hope that we can count on you for your support in the future. Thank you very much.
And so with this good fortune, with this platform, having made the first album in the history of the record business to ever sell 1 million copies, which set the standard for gold records and Grammys, all those things today came from that moment. Mm. With this, and the philosophy of Robeson buried deep in my heart and psyche, I was amazed at how many others sought me out to bring my voice, to bring my platform, to bring my constituency, the audiences of the world, to the thoughts of our struggle and to those who were in it. And this young man who called me from a buried place in the South, called and said, I have heard of you, and I hope you've heard of me because I would like to come visit. And I said, I've heard of you. You are no stranger to me, and I would gladly meet you. And so Martin Luther King came to New York, and together we sat in the basement of the Abyssinia Baptist Church. And for what was to be, like Robeson, a 20-minute short discourse, turned out to be a matter of hours. And that moment indelibly marked my life for his foreseeable future. He embraced me. He told me that he did not know the journey that he was on. He had come to it reluctantly, but he accepted the challenge. He had no idea where it would go, but he knew he could not make the journey alone, and he sought the assistance and the support of voices that he felt and he hoped could be trusted. And to have been given that invitation, to have been looked upon for having those credentials that he sought, was an opportunity for myself to be in service and to have lived with him the rest of his life, to have been in his service, to have been in the service of the struggle of not only our country, but all the peoples of this planet who sought the dignity of freedom, was a great mission on which to be on. And through him and his influence, to have been able to meet Ella Baker, to be able to meet Fannie Lou Hamer, to have come to know Malcolm X, and to sit with him, and to have exchange and debate, and to come to places of reasonable facts of our mutual bond in seeking to alleviate oppression, was a journey that I think there is no question about how blessed I have been. I would never have asked for it to be another way. When I was with Paul Jr., and we went in the last days of Paul Robeson's life, it was in his humble dwellings in Philadelphia. Paul took me to see him, and I sat with Paul, and I looked at him. His spirit was strong, his voice was strong, his soul was strong, his body was weak. And I said to him, "Paul, you have given so much. You could have been anything you wanted to be. You had money, you had fame, you had power. You spoke all the major languages of the world, literally spoke them, read them, and could write them. 14 of them, including Swahili and Zulu." And I said to him, "Was it worth it?" And the words you used just now, Danny, the journey, he said, "Absolutely. Weep not for me." He said, "We may not have gotten all the victories we wanted, but more important than the victories we have acquired and attained was the journey itself. The men and women whom I have met along the way have forever made my life a life of great value, and I would change absolutely nothing." And in that spirit, I can say that with all that has been my good fortune, with all that has smiled upon me, some of it deserved, some of it just sheer luck, most of it sheer luck, I would never have changed a minute of my experience for the woman who brought me into this world, for the men and women who enlightened me and embraced me along the way, and who gave my life purpose and meaning. And to be able to sit here in Washington, D.C., at the Lincoln Theater with you, talking to the youth of our community about our world, there is no richer reward than to be here and involved in this kind of moment and experience.
So it is a great pleasure and an honor for me to be able to present Harry Belafonte with this Paul Robeson Here I Stand Award. We all salute you, Brother Belafonte, and as our folk saying goes, God ain't finished with you yet.
Work all night and a drink of rum. Stack banana till the morning come. Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana.
Daylight come and me one go home.
Come, Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana.
Daylight daylight come and me one go home.
Live
6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot bunch. Daylight come and me one go home. 6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot bunch. Daylight come and me one go home.
Day is a day, oh. A beautiful bunch, a ripe banana.
Daylight come and me one go home.
Hide the deadly black tarantula.
Daylight come and me one go home.
Live
6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot bunch. Daylight come and me one go home. 6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot bunch.
Day, oh.
Daylight come and me one go home.
Day, is a day, is a day, is a day.
Daylight come and me one go home.
Come, Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana.
Daylight come and me one go home.
Come, Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana.
Daylight come and me one go home.
Deo, Deo,
daylight come and me one go home.
Deo, is that day, is that day, is that day, is that day.